All the teams that you are helping are the Scrum Master using the three questions in their daily stand-up. What did I do yesterday? What will I do today? And if anything is blocking me, are they using these three questions when running the daily stand-up? Maybe you feel that your daily stand-ups need some improvement. Maybe it's your first time ever running a daily stand-up and you don't know where to start. Well, I'm going to cover all this in this video. I'm going to give you a plan on how to make your next daily stand-up super effective. First off, no matter what happens, never skip a daily stand-up. Even a poorly optimized daily stand-up is still better than no stand-up. Because at least the team will be talking to each other, communicating, collaborating. Still better than no stand-ups. For those of you watching who might not know what a daily stand-up is, it's basically one of the Scrum, Agile Scrum events or ceremonies, which, as the name states, is run every single day with your team, usually at the beginning of the day. If you want to get a quick, simple, and very good example of what Agile Scrum is, watch this video right here. I gave you a quick analogy that you can use with anyone to explain Agile Scrum in under 2 minutes. Before telling you how to run an effective daily stand-up, it's important to understand why first. Why do we run the daily stand-ups? Why are they important? And the best place to get this answer is the Scrum Guide, which was recently updated in 2020. The purpose of a daily stand-up is to inspect progress towards the sprint goal and adapt the sprint backlog as necessary, adjusting the upcoming plan work. The daily Scrum is a 15-minute event for the developers of a Scrum team to reduce complexity. It is held at the same time and place every working day of a sprint. The developers can select whatever structure and techniques they want, as long as their daily Scrum focuses on progress towards the sprint goal and produces an actionable plan for the next day of work. This creates focus and improves self-management. Daily Scrums improve communications, identify impediments, promote quick decision-making, and consequently eliminate the need for other meetings. The most common way to run daily stand-ups, the most common structure people use when running their daily stand-ups, three questions, what did I do yesterday, what will I do today, is anything blocking me from doing my work? Any help I need? Anyone can help me? Please help me. These are the three questions that people use, most common three questions people use when running their daily stand-ups. I don't like this structure. I have some issues with that structure. Number one, some developers I've noticed, and many people have also noticed, some developers who want to make a good impression like to mention everything in my daily stand-up. They mention everything they are doing during the day, even meetings included, everything they do during the day. This kind of update is of little value to other team members, not to mention for the sprint goal. I don't like this approach. I don't like the each member giving a status update approach to the daily stand-up. That shouldn't be the goal of a stand-up. The goal of a stand-up, it's clear. The goal of a stand-up is, as a team, we build a plan for the day. How can we get closer to the sprint goal? How can we work together during the day, help each other out during the day to get closer to the sprint goal? And not only that, at the end of an update, at the end of a daily stand-up, if you use that format, look at the board. I guarantee you that some items on the board in progress would not have been mentioned by anyone. So what are we doing here? Are we managing people? Or are we working towards meeting the sprint goal? Ever been to a business meeting or any type of meeting where not everyone knows each other? In these kinds of meetings, people usually introduce themselves clockwise fashion, one after the other. They talk about who I am, what do I do, where am I from, one after the other. Let me ask you a simple question. The person prior to you, usually the person to your right, when this person was talking, when this person was introducing themselves, or even the person before him, what were you thinking about? Well, most people here would be thinking about what they're going to say next when their turn comes, instead of listening to the person just before them, or the people that talked just before them. Not paying attention, they are crafting the answer in their mind, and the same thing happens for the daily stand-up if you use a three questions format. No one is paying attention. Everyone is waiting for their turn and crafting the answer in their mind. No one is trying to analyze the answer, examine, inspect the answer of other people. How can I help the other person get things done today? No one is doing that. Everyone is selfish, crafting the answer in their mind to talk next.
Don't use this format with three questions, it's outdated. Walk the board instead
of focusing on what people did yesterday and what they will do today. Focus on how can we work together today to meet, to get closer to our sprint goal.
Again, the three questions format gives the impression that it's a status meeting, that we are interested in what people did yesterday and what people are doing today. No one cares about that.
Our only concern in the daily standup is focusing on the sprint goal. How can we work together as a team to reach or get closer to our sprint goal? And the best way that I know of to do it is to forget about people and focus on the gods instead.
Walking the board, super simple to do. Tell your team that you're going to facilitate the next daily stand-up session.
It's going to be a new format, super entertaining format. Pay attention.
So when you walk in the board, you start, it's super simple. You start from the right and you go to left, where right should be your done column. So you start with a column closest to a done column. And for each gods in this column, ask questions. Where are we at for this card? And most importantly, well, usually when you ask questions, the person working on the card will start talking about the card. Okay, this card is, we need to do XXXY feature. And you ask questions, are there any blockers? Can we help you get this card done? Do you need help getting this card done? When do you think this card will be done? Can we get this done today?
And let the person who is working on the card answer all these questions. And once done, you move on to the next card and you keep asking questions. And once the column is done, you move to the column to the left of this column that you just completed. And you keep going until all the columns are completely done. I don't usually do a to-do column because we shouldn't be starting things. We should be completing things. Which brings me to the most important question to ask in this standard. For each card or general question that you can ask, what can we complete today?
And very important here, don't answer this question yourself. Don't tell the team what to do. Let the team come up with a plan. A self-organized team comes up with a plan on what they will do together today to get things done today, which will move us closer to the sprint goal.
Another good experiment that you can try to give a boost in vitality to your daily standups is to rotate the facilitator.
This has so many benefits. First, you will not be required to facilitate all the daily standups, so you can focus on other things or chill. And second, everyone in the team will have a chance to facilitate the session, so they will increase their skill in facilitation, asking questions. They want to understand the board better, how the team works, the sprint goal, what we do in the sprint, how to tackle each card, how to help each other. That's beneficial to anyone in the team, and the team will grow because of that. And third, the team becomes the owner of a session because they are handling the session themselves without the intervention of a scrum master.
You can start by rotating the facilitator on a weekly basis. So at the end of a week on Friday, let's say the end of a week is Friday for you, the facilitator, the current facilitator, will pick someone else to facilitate the next week, starting Monday up to Friday. Simple strategy to pick the next facilitator. And I recommend doing it on a weekly basis instead of a daily basis. When you do it on a weekly basis, the person facilitating will understand more the sprint goal. We'll have more context because they are facilitating the whole week, and we help the team most probably ask better question, more powerful questions to the team because they understand the context, they are used to it, and this will get things done better. You'll reach the sprint goal faster. But you can try also rotating on a daily basis or every 3 days. Just experiment with it.
If you want more tips, insights on Agile, Scrum, personal growth, click on the video that stands out the most on the screen right now, and I'll see you in a few seconds.